Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I really hope you're all doing well. Today I'm back with a Louis Vuitton repair update video as well as an unboxing, and I'm very much excited to chit chat with you guys and give you, you know, some hints that I found out. But first of all, I really want to announce the winner of this giveaway, and to my surprise, it's a dear friend of mine. If you guys don't know, I hosted a giveaway in my last video, and here we are. I'm just announcing the winner, and the winner is... It's Matt by Dear Matt. Yay! I'm so excited. I was very surprised when I, you know, picked randomly with, you know, I picked randomly the comment of the winner. So I was so happy. I just want to show you what was actually in the giveaway. So I'm giving away this Organize My Bags chains, two of them, you know, which you could use on some of your accessories or, you know, handbags to dress them up or use them as a crossbody. And you guys, if you are interested in getting any of the Organize My Bag straps or strap chains, I will put down below a link where you can go and have a look, and if you would like to shop, you can even use my coupon code so you get 10% off at the checkout. And yeah, Matt, I'm so happy you were able to win this one, so congratulations. I will reach out to you via text message. All right, let's jump into the unboxing. There you go, guys. So yesterday I went and picked up this item. I don't remember in which video I mentioned it, but I mentioned that I really wanted to get this one for my Pochette Matisse. And it was so tough. It was very, very hard to track it down. It was kind of sold out online. It was sold out in any store seen in Switzerland. And finally, I was able to find one last piece. So I let them ship it to my store here where I'm living. And I'm going to show you what it is. You probably guess already. Da, 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 da. Yay! So as you can tell, is the Louis Vuitton Since 1854 bandoulier in the gray. This is the way it's named online, and I purchased this strap to go specifically to my Pochette Matisse. Oh, let me show you. This is my Pochette Matisse in the black unprint leather, and as you can tell, this one has a navy blue or grayish touch, and here in the interior is made out of black calfskin leather. So it goes so nice with my beautiful Pochette Matisse, and I will definitely put some mud shots so I can show you how this will look on me. However, guys, I'm a little bit disappointed because, as you can tell, that the strap is quite short. For some reason, I didn't pay attention on the measurements online. I just assumed it's a bandoulier strap, you know, to carry the back crossbody. But not really, guys. I mean, I can wear the bags, you know, on my shoulder, and it looks quite nice. I even can make it crossbody. However, it's not the right way where the bag should hit me, because the other strap is approximately 10 centimeters longer, and it hits me right on my hips, versus this one is gonna hit me a little bit like above, like on my belly. And I don't know, I'm so disappointed. That was a real fail purchase. I'm so disappointed, especially because I was, you know, lusting over this bandoulier, and I was really, really looking if I can find it online, if I can find it in any stores. I even saw that there was one available in Italy. I was about to call the Italy store from Switzerland, you know, to make them ship it to me. And yeah, that makes it even more disappointed that the strap is that short. I didn't expect it at all. And again, it looks very nice with this empreinte leather. It goes so well. But, you know, for the cost of this bandoulier, it is just not worth it to me if I can't wear it the way I want it, you know. And I paid 490 Swiss francs, which is 410 euros. Way too expensive for, you know, something that is not perfect in my eyes. But the strap, guys, is absolutely well made. As you can tell here, it is cotton and the details, it's absolutely beautiful. The strap is very, very comfortable. If you're looking after a strap on this size, I think the strap itself is 90 centimeters. I would need 10 more. I would need about 100 centimeters to make it the perfect crossbody for my body frame. But anyway, guys, that was a little fail to me, and I will probably bring it back today. You know, I will return the strap. All right, the next thing I want to discuss is my repair update on this Neverfull. And I posted a video on my Louis Vuitton repair experience a while back. I will definitely put it, you know, link it up here in case you are interested. You know, feel free to watch it. I did mention that I brought in this handbag to repair, or basically to replace the whole vacchetta, since I had, you know, I had a damage on here. You know, I had a damage on this piece of leather, so I brought it in and I asked them to replace the entire vacchetta on this handbag. With that, what happened? It happens that they removed my date gold, or they didn't put it back the way it should be. So as you know, the Neverfulls have their date gold behind this pocket, and you should be able to see it. If you just lift the pocket, you should be able to see a piece of leather where the date gold is engraved in the leather. Now, as you can tell, there is no piece of leather. It is an authentic handbag. It's my monogram handbag. You don't see it, however, I can feel it. So I can definitely feel that my date coat, the piece of leather where the date coat is in, is being stitched together with this piece of leather. So they probably by mistake stitched it in it, or maybe they forgot to remove it. I wasn't really sure if that's a process of Louis Vuitton, if you bring in an item where you ask for a repair close to the date code, if they have to remove the date code, or I don't know if that's the process. Anyway, I texted my SA when I noticed it when I was back home. I texted my SA, but because we were in lockdown, I had to wait until these stores open again. So I went in yesterday and I knew that there wasn't anything I could do or she could do unless I ask her to send this back in again, restitch, you know, like reopen this piece of leather, put the date code back and stitch it back. So I wasn't going to do that, to be honest, because I don't want them to touch this handbag again. I feel like the repair went very nice, it's well made, and I just don't want to risk it, you know, that then something goes wrong. So I will live with that my date code is stitched in it. But I asked her to please check with the manufacturer, first of all, to give them this feedback and check with them if that's the right process, you know, because it happened to me already once with my Montsouris backpack. I brought it in as well for repair. I let them replace the whole vacchetta, and wherever the date code was, with putting a new vacchetta on, they didn't engrave the date code back to the vacchetta. So I have now a backpack, an authentic backpack by Louis Vuitton with no date code, and that's the second one. Now, what I found out while discussing with her is that Louis Vuitton, and I'm not sure if you guys know, but these are news to me, you know. I found out that Louis Vuitton apparently wants to replace the date code with a chip. So all handbags won't have a visible date code anymore, and I'm not sure by when this is going to apply, if it's, you know, this year, this spring, this summer, or in fall, or if they already started. I'm not sure, but at some point you will purchase handbags which have a chip, and that chip will basically prove the authenticity of the item. So no date code, no visible date code anymore, and that, guys, makes it even more difficult to buy things pre-loved. And I believe they want to, with that, they want to stop or reduce the pre-love, you know, the buy and sell situation on the pre-love market. Also because obviously with that the replicas traffic is even higher, you know. So I get it. I know what where in which direction they want to go. However, it's so disappointed again and sad that they want to restrict the buyer to resell their item. Of course you can sell it. We have to go. I mean, even though we won't stop resell our item, but you have to trust. You have to trust the person that is selling. And in this case, it's even more important now to purchase the item with an invoice or an authenticity card or, you know, something that can definitely prove the authenticity of the handbag. So this is what is going to happen. That were news to me. What I also noticed, guys, I noticed that the new Never Fools. Remember when I asked you in my last video, I asked if the strap on the new Never Fools were thick because I remembered mine, the older strap that I had on, were thinner, and actually my Never Fool MM in Dame Azur has thinner strap versus this new one now by being replaced. The straps are thicker. So when I went in yesterday, I asked my SA to please show me a Never Fool. And yes, in fact, the new Never Fools have thicker straps. And also the zipper here, the leather on the zipper is not squared like this one. As you can tell here, it's like square. Can we say square? Like re rectangular. The new leather has a pointy leather, you know, it ends pointy here. And if I can find a picture, I will definitely try to put a picture to show you what I mean. And you know, things change. They replace, they update some certain things on handbags. I get it. I'm not sure if it's always for the better. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. You know, it's like the Speedy that they put now a zipper in it versus before the pocket didn't have a zipper. And what I also found out is that the key pals now have a zipper pocket inside. So I bought mine, when was it? I believe I bought my key pal in 2013, and it's just plain, you know, without any pockets. There is just a D ring. Now the key pals have a zipper pocket inside, and of course the price justifies that pocket. It reflects, obviously. I mean, they can't just keep increasing their prices without really updating or uplifting, you know, the value of the handbag. So they are trying to do, you know, like new pockets or zippers or whatever it is. And I think it's a good way to justify the price. However, now I am a little bit sad that my Keepall has no zipper compartment in it, and I feel like, oh, do I really want now to get the new version with the zipper pocket? But anyway, I just wanted to give you this quick information, you guys, about, you know, update on my Never Fool. There won't be anything I can really do unless I'm asking her to send it in and make sure my date code is again out. But you know, with the new regulation that they will apply in a couple of months, you know, not having a visible date code anymore, but replacing in it with a chip, it solves the issue of this handbag too, for me at least, you know. And yeah, you guys, this is it for today's video. I don't have anything else to say. I really hope you enjoyed watching it, and I will be back very soon with another video that's very excited, and I'm happy to record it. And until then, I wish you all a very good day or night wherever you are. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and see you soon on my next video. Bye.